You know what? Something weird happened yesterday when I was trying to find a way out of there. Hello.
In fact, it was Stan Sitwell calling her, as he'd become quite taken with Lucille, too, himself.
You know, it all makes sense. I mean, why else would Sally Sitwell be avoiding me?
Because she thinks you're a loser.
And why would Lucille, too, be so distant toward me?
Because she knows you're a loser.
Well, I think it's pretty clear. Lucille, too, and Sitwell are working on a business deal. Lindsay, I'd like for you to go over to Sitwell and see what you can find out. I can't go there again.
Why do I have to do that?
Because you've been helping yourself to the company money for quite some time. It's not like you do anything for the family anyway.
Well, Job doesn't do anything for the family.
Hey, I'm f***ing Lucille, too.
Oh, I could do something like that.
Yeah, this is what Dad was really good at, getting us out of tight spots.
In fact, at that very moment, George Sr. was in a tight spot, as he'd gotten himself wedged under the furnace while chasing after a sour ball that had rolled out of his pocket. Eventually, Michael rescued him.
I'm just starting to worry that she's going to sell us out.
I think the answer to this problem is money. Now, this may just be me having my head against a 100-degree furnace for an hour, but maybe we should bring in Jack Dorso.
Uncle Jack?
Well, no, he's not my uncle. He's my dad's friend, but this guy has got a fortune.
Jack Dorso first achieved success in the 40s as a co-star of the radio and then film serial Red McKibbon and Bullet, Nazi Hunters.
There are two Nazis up there in that dance hall.
Shoot me! Happy Valentine's Day, Nazis!
When the actor who played Red McKibbon was jailed for his communist sympathies, Jack Dorso made one attempt at a solo Bullet feature. But the audience was not ready to accept Bullet as a romantic lead, despite his powerful upper body. So he started a chain of gymnasiums, having stolen the idea from Red during a prison visit. And as the years passed,
hey Jack!
He became well known for his annual birthday feats of strength.
£5 for each year of my life!
Sadly, he lost the use of his legs on his 70th
Release!
Birthday at the newly remodeled Jack Dorso's in Albany, New York.
Too much!
Well, if he's got so much money, how come we never called him before?
But I have. I mean, there wouldn't be a Bluth company without him. I could never have afforded that first tract of land. But he always wants something in return. I don't know. See if you can talk your mother into taking another bullet for the Bluth family.
You know, Michael, I was happy to call Uncle Jack for you, but that's as much as I'm going to do. If you know what I mean. I need a more vital man.
Someone order 140 pounds of upper body strength?
Well, he certainly sounds vital to me.
Walk, dragon, walk! Enter the room!
Welcome, Uncle Jack.
Hi. He's half deaf. It was a stupid hire. Not hire! Eye level! Eye level! Kisses, and then we talk. Which one is Michael? Swoop me!
I really appreciate you coming over, Uncle Jack.
Thank you for having me. You may be amazed. I'm invited into very few personal homes. To the nuts! The bridge mix! The bridge mix! Fool!
Hey, fake Uncle Jack.
Oh, is this the boy? Is this the little one? My God, you're an army man.
I was never in the army. I was in the pictures. Here comes Uncle Jack. Shoot me!
Oh! Oh, yeah. Oh! Look at that. I pinned him. I pinned the army man. God bless you for being in the army. Up, dragon! Left! Left with vigor!
Remember me?
Lucille. Why, you look younger than you did the day I...
Oh, you old fool. I'm Lucille.
Ah! You look fabulous. Back to the blonde. Back to the blonde. Isn't she beautiful? Oh, yeah.
It's kind of scary, that guy, huh?
No, not to me. I think he's kind of cool.
Well, why don't you go get your kiss from Mr. Cool Half Man?
Okay, I'd be fine
Let's
with
go.
That. So what's your
plan?
She's no bigger than one of my legs. Shake them for her.
Excuse me, Uncle Jack. I'm George Michael.
It's okay. Just ignore it. Ignore it. Just something the body does when you shake it. Don't shake it. Don't shake it. Help!
Not the good one. Is he dying? What if he's dying?